Howdy folks, it's me again, your Chief Marine Mate, Edu. This is a continuation of the Part 6 LPG cargo operations. But before anything else, kindly click the subscribe button, notification bell, and click like if it pleases you. Let's begin!
Now, let's do a little bit of recapitulations on the previous topic or video segment, which is Part 5C. We were able to complete the loading and the top of the tanks with the right amount or cargo quantity that has been nominated. And then of course we have completed the calculations and we have a so-called bill of lading. Now understand that we are now proceeding to the discharging port. So basically we have already started the cargo conditioning right there from the completion of loading. So in cargo conditioning or loaded voyage passage, cargo procedures while the vessel is at sea depend on what has been stated in the charter party. Some cargoes are to be discharged fully refrigerated while others at a given temperature. Now this is of course depends on the kind of gas carrier that we are talking about, but since we have used a model LPG ships which is fully refrigerated, then we should be able to concentrate on that kind of operation. However, we might just of course include as well the other kinds of gas carrier so that there's a bigger perspective, or you'll be able to have a greater understanding. With fully pressurized, this is without the refrigeration or liquefaction plant, then cargo conditioning is a little bit easier. Of course, all you need to do is to maintain the pressures of the tank. And of course, and in this case, the tank itself has been designed at a higher pressure, which of course is, that's why it's called fully pressurized containment system. While with semi-pressurized and fully refrigerated vessel, these are the example of ethylene gas carrier, they are more robust because ethylene of course yields higher pressure, and at the same time you have greater requirements in temperature maintaining. And in most cases, as per experience, you are actually maintaining the cargo conditioning almost basically the whole length of the voyage. From loading to discharge, the plants are actually in full operation. And of course, that depends on the type of ships that you have been assigned to. I mean to say, there are ships which cargo plants are very much state-of-the-art and very new, newly fitted, and of course their performance are quite higher than the old ones, and hence of course with this kind of capability, then conditioning is a little bit easier. But with older ships for ethylene, it takes a while, and basically, as I mentioned earlier, you have already started conditioning from the point of departure from your loading port, and as soon as you arrive, it's just almost exactly on time when you have completed meeting up the right temperature. And that's the difference with some ships like ethylene. Now with regards to fully refrigerated but not semi-pressurized, and this is of course you really have to maintain the plants running also at the same time, but with the cargoes like propane and butane, it's a little bit easier, meaning to say you might do a conditioning at the daytime wherein you have the peak of the warmest temperature of the certain region. It depends of course also where you are making your voyage. Say if you are in the area of the Middle East and during the summer, it's of course warmer and the plant will work harder. And it also of course other than that, the atmosphere or the ambient temperature from the outside is warmer, the water also could be a little bit warmer, and with that your plant performance will of course affected. And then of course at night time, chances are you'll be able to stop the plant and then of course resume again the following day as the sun goes up, because like has been mentioned in the previous topics, with regards to thermodynamics, warmer region goes towards colder region, and your tank with your cargo in it are colder. So most cases, definitely the warmer region will always get inside, and hence of course this will now make your cargo boil off faster. Now, with regards to LNG, of course, in this present day, there are two applications now, especially with those newly built vessels. Those are the Q-Plex and Q-Max, as they call it. When it's fitted with reliquefaction plant, or in most cases, they call it as recondensing plant. And typically, it's just a skid type combination of plant wherein basically they utilize liquid nitrogen to recondense the methane. Other than that, if of course in excess of pressure and the plant for recondensation cannot meet it, then it cannot cope up with the condition, then the excess vapor will of course can be utilized by the engine as a fuel. So those with the engine like the dual fuel diesel engine, these are very useful. And of course, the conventional type, the earliest one, for like the most Rosenbergs, which engine is of the steam turbine engine. So this is almost the same principle, actually. They use the fuel or methane gas as a fuel to burn and create steam through the boiler. Where for the dual fuel, then you are actually utilizing directly as a fuel, injecting it to mix up with air and create combustion, and then there you go. You have a combustion that will be able to turn the turbine, and the turbine could turn an electric or generator, and the generator would be able to turn the shaft for the propeller. And we have also the so-called electric type of engine fitted for LNG. And these are kind of vessels are mostly fitted now with the membrane type of containment. So this is basically what is all about with regards to the cargo conditioning. Now, let's go back to the some aspects that you should know. During the topping off, I mentioned that the vapor, of course, will always remain open, especially with one cargo. And that is all common in one line. And at the same time, your bulkhead valves are closed. This is the labeling valve. So I'm going to show you an animation and explain to you the reason for this. Okay, I mentioned a while ago about the bulkhead valves or labeling valves. And since we focus on this fully refrigerated LPG type, and the containment design is a prismatic. So basically, as I have also discussed in previous segments of gas carriers, the prismatic type, a kind of containment system for LPG, has a bulkhead in the middle. So it's one tank basically, but it is divided into two. Now, during loading, basically, since there is a bulkhead, it will restrict the flow of liquid through the other side. So with that, they have to utilize a labeling valve. So meaning to say, a valve in between or just below, close to the bottom of the tanks, and in the middle of the bulkhead is a labeling valve. So while loading, this is basically open, and at the same time, the liquid line or drop line, sometimes as we call it, loading lines, will of course be throttled. Because as you load, as you can notice in the simulation, when you are loading, and if the throttling valves or liquid valves are not throttled in a where the flow is even, then chances are your vessel will heel or list to where the liquid has the most. And so of course, throttling the valves for the loading line will of course settle it and control it, and eventually this will become upright as soon as the level in the tanks are of the same level. So that's the use of throttling the valve in the liquid lines. Now at the same time, the liquid passes through the bulkhead because of the labeling valve. Now the reason that there is a bulkhead in a prismatic type is because, unlike LNG, if you remove the bulkheads, then you have a bigger space of the tank area. And this is quite very important when it comes to so-called pre-surface effects or FSE. Now, in stability, pre-surface effects is basically what we call as a negative GM. Now, to give you a more understanding with this, when you have a so-called pre-surface effects and you accumulate all this in your ballast tanks, fuel tanks, and your, of course, the biggest spaces are your cargo tanks, then this so-called pre-surface effects, when you add and sum them up, it will be a negative GM. So to give you the right perspective, if you have, say for example, if you are looking at a finishing GM of about, say, this is just an example, 2 meters. And with the pre-surface effects, let's say it has summed up to about negative 2.3. So take note, you have a finishing GM or metacentric height of 2 meters, but then your FSE will become like negative 2.3. So what happens is that your final GM will be negative 0.3. So in short, your metacentric height is not actually above the center of gravity, but it's actually below. So if let's say for example that you have also the same FSE with your GM, say 2 meters for the GM, and then you have an FSE of negative GM of 2.0, so you are now in neutral. So any process that could affect your vessels like wind, then your vessel will definitely turn from left to right because it's already neutral. But if you have a negative, then of course I'll exaggerate it with this animation. I'll just turn the vessel to the reverse position. So now you are looking at a vessel capsized because of that pre-surface. So that's the reason that the bulkhead is there. And when I mentioned a while ago that it should be closed, well, upon completion of loading, it's because you don't want those liquids to transfer from one side to the other, especially, let's say, if you just loaded to about 90% and you still have an allowable space on each side of the bulkheads. So thereby, if you are listing from one side to the other due to rolling and pitching, then the liquid will transfer and, of course, your stability will change dynamically. Of course, it always changes as the vessel is moving, but it will change a lot if there is a shifting of liquid and it stays in that place. And what happens is that it changes the GM significantly. But when the bulb is closed and you have a right level of equal level of liquids, then everything is stabilized. That's why we call it stability. So it's stabilized, right? And of course, the capability or the ability of the vessel to be upright at all times, even with, of course, you have wind effects, rolling and pitching and the waves. So it's dynamic, it's pitching and rolling, but it always goes back to its upright position as long as the forces, outside forces, has minimized or stabilized. So that's the purpose. Now, with LNG-like membrane, they don't have a bulkheads because the reason is very logical. You see, the thickness of the material utilized in LNG, the stainless steel, for this primary membrane and the secondary barrier, or primary barrier and secondary barrier, it's just about 0.7 millimeter to 1.2 millimeter thickness. That's very thin. So these membrane types of cargo containment are basically holding each other through that kind of membrane and insulation design. So they are not like these oil tankers that they are integrated into the ship's hull. It's literally not connected to the ship's hull. It's a membrane, while the prismatic is also not an integrated type, but it's a little bit more robust because it is utilizing mild steel. And of course, you can actually put in a bulkhead, but with a stainless steel of about 0.7 millimeter to 1.2 millimeter, of course, whatever you can, whatever you would like to do with it, you cannot actually put up a bulkhead in the middle. One, what kind of thickness of bulkhead you would put in that will be able to hold in place with that 0.7 or 1.2 millimeter thickness of stainless steel? it is not possible at all. So loading with LNG for membrane type, there are only two options you have. It's either you are close to full, about 98% to 99%, or when you have discharged, should be fully empty, fully loaded or empty. That's basically applicable also with the other liquid tanks, like your ballast tanks and even fuel. So of course you cannot control all those things like the fuel. There are of course slack tanks, and some slack tanks will be transferred to make the other tanks full. But with ballast tanks, when you are the ballasting, then it should be stripped off completely, and when you are ballasting, then it should be full. So that's the difference with this prismatic type and with the LNG. Well, of course, with the spherical type, it's a little bit different because it's spherical. So the surface, when it gets to the area where it's already full, there's smaller space compared to the prismatic and then the membrane type. While at the other hand, if you have the so-called type B SPB, the one that is created by IHI of Japan, that's the kind of LNG that you can actually load LNG cargoes at any kind of levels, because one, it has a bulkheads, it has a lot of compartments, but it's considered as one tank, and it is more robust in design. But of course, that's another topic when we go to LNG. So anyway, that's just I want to remind you about the bulkheads and the leveling bulbs. They should be close when it's unloaded passage. It's only the condensate line that will be open eventually when you are sending in condensate returns, and of course at all times the vapor lines bulbs are open. And if you have one single cargo, then they are all of course in common line, open all together, so that the pressure will be more stable and stabilized.